One of the primary obstacles to intra-regional business and leisure travel is high airfare costs, which are compounded by various fees and taxes across different territories. The Caribbean Development Bank and the Caribbean Hotel and Tourism Association have proposed reducing these fees and taxes to make air travel more affordable. A suggestion that St. Lucia's Tourism Minister Dr. Ernest Hilaire agrees with.
Personally, I support we making regional airfares lower. I really do. As somebody who grew up in this region, traveling between the islands for sports, for youth activities, I'm a big fan of making regional travel more affordable.
While this may be the personal view of the tourism minister, Prime Minister Philip Pierre says St. Lucia has not yet taken a position on reducing taxes on airline tickets.
The tourism minister made the point that government should consider reduction of taxes. Again, these are issues that I think we should approach them regionally. You may recall when the last government imposed the airport departure tax, when the last government increased it, we were of the view that that may have done something to travel. The statistics say that the more taxes are disincentive to travel. But you know, in this business of fiscal issues, fiscal deficits, fiscal problems, there's a need for social expenditure, need for expenditure on education. Governments have to look for ways where they can collect money. And unfortunately, collecting money on airlines are the easiest way. It's a very easy way to get revenue, bad ticket to pay. Very easy way. But the idea of reducing the tax is something that can be considered. Solution has not taken a position in this regard.
At a recent CARICOM Heads of Government retreat in Dominica, leaders discussed various challenges with regional travel, including recent disruptions that left travelers stranded across the island chain. Prime Minister Pierre acknowledges that addressing these issues is a work in progress. He believes that a regional approach is the best way to tackle them.
We just recently removed the VAT on aircrafts. So who knows, maybe some private sector person may get involved in it. But it's work in progress. As I said, St. Lucia has not paid any regional airline directly in terms of solving that problem. But it's something that we are taking a regional approach. I know the Caribbean Development Bank, they're in the process of completing a study to give advice on these issues. But it continues, the problem continues. Our regional tourism is suffering because of that, but it's work in progress. But St. Lucia has not paid any airline directly, regional directors. But in fact, I understand that Caribbean Airways would be increasing some flights to St. Lucia between Trinidad and St. Lucia and possibly between Barbados and St. Lucia. So that may help us.
CARICOM heads have committed to enabling free movement between the 13 member countries of the Caribbean single market and economy by early 2024. Improving intra-regional travel will need to be a priority to help make this dream a reality. For the DBS News World, I am Zin Romulus.